Praise the Lord. We welcome you all to this Solution Hour today, this week, and this month. Today we'll be having a special session because of the epidemic that is going on in the world. Before we go into the Word of God briefly, we are going to pray. Let us pray. Almighty Father, we thank you because power in heaven, on earth, under the heaven, are in your hand. No man has power apart from you. And none of us can deliver ourselves from trouble. Only you can deliver us from trouble. Jesus told us, pray. The Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come. And Lord, you told us, we shall ask for our daily bread. You told us that you will deliver us from every form of temptation. We know we are living in the hour of temptation. We are living in the hour of trouble. We are living in the hour of calamity. God of heaven, you are the solution to every man's problem. Please give us solution. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Once again, I want to welcome everybody to today's session. We'll be spending such a chunk of our time to pray. We are having this special session because it takes faith now to live in these our days because of the problem of COVID-19. This has sent a lot of panic into the world. And every nation in the world is in trouble. Many nations are closing their borders to the foreigners, to the travelers, to the people that are coming in. The government is doing a good job. Even though this is affecting our economy, it's affecting our movement, the stock market and the world market are plummeting. Santa could no longer hold. In fact, a friend of mine sent me an article some 3 days ago. In that article, there was a book that was written that a man was predicting that in the year 2020, there will be a catastrophe. And this catastrophe we call lung bronchial tube infection and problem. And this problem will resist every known treatment. And when you are watching the news, you will see they are talking about this pandemic. World Health Organization has declared that it was a serious issue, and it is still a serious problem. Thousands of people have lost their lives. Hundreds of thousands have been infected and affected by this COVID-19. And when you look at the news and you look at the map of the world and you look at the areas that have been affected by this virus, it has been a serious issue. Sometimes you look at the picture of the world, everywhere there was it's painted red. And that shows again the red map of the world. And an idea came to my mind that even though the world had been painted red, we have Jesus who can walk upon the storm. When there was a storm in Galilee, in the Sea of Galilee, Jesus walked upon the storm. In situations that has happened in different areas, Jesus had been walking upon the storm. When these leprous people came to Jesus, they were defiled. They touched Jesus. Instead of their defilement affecting Jesus, Jesus' power affected their defilement. And their defilement changed to purification. Healing happens in them. You remember the story of a woman that had been carrying issue of blood for 12 years. This woman came in contact with Jesus and touched Jesus, and that calamity just vanished away. You remember the story of a man that was staying by the pool of Bethesda. He was looking for somebody to take him into that water, but there was none. And Jesus got there, and just one word, that man was completely healed. So that's why I'm looking at the title of the message today, which says, Jesus walking, or Jesus in the red world map. Because our world map has been painted red. The only person that can turn it to normal is Jesus Christ. Isaiah chapter 4 verse 6 says, that there will be a tabernacle from the chairs in the daytime from the heat, for a place of refuge and for a shelter from storm and rain. In that particular passage of the Bible, Isaiah made us to understand that there's going to be a tabernacle. Remember, we are living in a world that is broken. And because our world is broken as a result of sin that Adam and Eve committed, which is transferred to every humanity, this has made our world to be broken. And you can't live in a broken world without a mortal body. Our body is given and susceptible to all kinds of infections. Bacterial infections are there, virus infections are there, airborne diseases are there, contact diseases are there, a lot of problems and calamities are there. So we are the product of mortality. And the only person who can walk through our immortality is the immortal one, the one that lives forever. The one that is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. He is the only one that can change our mortality to immortality. You remember that in 2002 as well as 2003, we have this problem of SARS all over the world. That is coronavirus 2. And that one killed thousands of people. In 2012, we have MERS. That affected people. Look at the issue of flu that came around in the land that killed thousands and thousands of people as well. And look at this Wuhan primordial problem too that is coming around, syndrome that has come over the world as well, killing people. In Italy, more than 1,000 people have died. In China, many people have died. Over here in America, people are dying to 100. Australia too is reporting some other problem. So countries all over the world, they are facing this problem because of the mortal nature of our being. But we need to understand, Paul the Apostle tells all that for sins by man, death came. Because death is passing from man to man, we inherit death. We live by death. We walk by death. But one thing we need to realize that even though death came upon man as a result of the sin of Adam and Eve, and this plague come up as a result of our broken world, there is an assurance we have in verse 21 of 1 Corinthians 15 that says, for sins by man came death. He went further to say, by man came also the resurrection from the dead. That's the assurance we have. Man brought sin. Through man, that sin shall be worked out. Three things we need to look at in our passage today. He said, and there will be a tabernacle for shade in the daytime from the heat. That tells us about the condition. There is a condition that has caused this problem. The condition of heat. For a place of refuge, that means there is danger. The condition of danger. And a shelter from storm and rain. That shows the thing that can really happen in the world. Look at it. The condition we are facing in the world is currently the condition of death and danger. It's a condition that nobody is sure of tomorrow. Somebody can be hale and hearty now, in the next 2 weeks he may be dead. And all kinds of problems may be there. Jesus' disciples face the same problem like we are. You remember the story when they went inside the boat and Jesus Christ was sleeping in the boat. And the storm came on the boat. And the disciples of Jesus Christ went to Jesus and said, Master, Master, we are finished. Except you rise up and help us, there's nothing we can do. These disciples told Jesus Christ about the condition they were. That's in Matthew chapter 8. And they were talking about the condition. They said, the boat is flooded. The storm is coming. If Christ did not intervene in this situation, they are going to perish. They sink, the boat will sink, and they will be drowned and perish. These men regarded and they knew that their condition was as good as being dead men. That is the same thing with us today. We are as good as dead men. It was a matter of death. It was a matter of time before death will come if Jesus did not rise up to save them. God knows our condition. Like he knew the condition of the children of Israel when they were in Egypt. No wonder he told us in Exodus chapter 3 verse 8. The Bible says, so I have come down to deliver them out of the hand of the Egyptians, because he knew their condition, and bring them all from that land to a good and a large land, to a land flowing with milk and honey, to the place of the Canaanites and the Hittites and the Amorites and the Amorites and the Perizzites and the Hivites and the Jebusites. So you see that it was God that came into their situation to help them out. That God, who is the same yesterday, today, and forever, who knows our condition, we step into our matter. Not only condition. There was a cry. In that passage, the Bible says, these disciples came to Jesus Christ and awoke him and said, Lord, save us. We are perishing. There was a cry. They knew the condition where they were. The dear condition which they find themselves. And they cried unto God for salvation. Christ came to save them from perishing. And the Bible made us to understand, for this purpose was the Son of God manifested, that he might destroy the works of the devil. The purpose of Jesus Christ coming into the world is that he might destroy the devil. And this particular problem we are facing now in the world is the work of the devil to send many people into hell. And Jesus came to deliver and set people free from the pang of trouble. This agent of the devil that has come around destroying people, causing commotions here and there, Jesus appeared that he might destroy the works of the devil. But note something. Knowing the condition is not enough. Yes, we take all the precautions that are necessary. That you know the condition is not enough for the problem. There is need for us to call. The Bible made us to understand that whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Acts of Apostles chapter 2 verse 21 says that it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Do you remember the story of the Ninevites? When Jonah went there and preached the gospel to them, and they repented, and they turned away, and they called upon the name of the Lord, and God delivered them. Whosoever call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Either you a believer or not a believer, you call upon the name of the Lord, you will be saved. The Bible tells us in 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14, if my people, which I called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face. That's what God said. That's talking about crying unto God. If you cry unto God and I cry unto God, and we turn away from our wicked ways, then God said, I will hear from heaven, and we forgive their sin, and I will heal their land. So we need to call upon the Lord. This thing is challenging unto us. It's a problem. It can take away the elderly, it can take away the young, it can kill, it can destroy. Because it has destroyed people from different ages. And we need to realize that despite the power of this disease, God Almighty has the power to deliver us when we call upon His name. Now, look at what happened. When you realize the condition and you cry, what is the result that you're going to get? There will be a calming. The condition is there, the cry is there, then God will rebuke the storm. Jesus will rebuke the storm, and there will be a calm. Look at what we are told in Matthew chapter 8, verse 26. But he said unto them, why are you so fearful, you of little faith? Then he arose and rebuked the wind and the sea, and there was a great calm. That's all we are asking for. This week we are going to pray, God, arise, rebuke this wind, rebuke this storm, put an end to this epidemic, and there will be a great calm. Christ brought a great calm upon the Sea of Galilee. When the disciples sought deliverance, when they cry unto God, because Jesus is the Prince of Peace, His duty is to bring peace upon the earth. Where things are not settled, is to bring peace there. As the world is worried with full awareness of the danger, let's look unto Christ, the finisher and the author of our faith, who is going to deliver us out of the problem, and He will come and save us. Look at what we are told. Isaiah chapter 41 verse 6, fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yea, I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. That's what God is saying. So all we need to do is just to trust in Him and come to Him. This special week, we want to pray. God promised that He's going to strengthen. God promised He's going to be with us. God promised He's going to abide with us. That He will deliver. Surely He will surely deliver. In Psalm 91 verse 4, God says, He shall cover you with His feather, and under His wings you shall take refuge. His truth shall be your shield and buckler. So that's the place what the Bible is telling us. His truth will be our shield and buckler. That God Himself is going to form a shield around us so that all these problems will be overpassed. We are going to spend time today to pray. And I want us to pray. We want to call upon the Lord. concerning this COVID-19, that God of heaven, He, the God of solution, will bring solution to this problem. Because God wants us to be wise. When God is talking about calming this problem, we should not act foolishly. There are people that are drinking all kinds of things they shouldn't drink. Some are even drinking bleach. That is poisonous. That can destroy. Some other people are bathing with hot water. Some are bathing with alcohol. Some are drinking alcohol. Some are thinking in themselves and then that if we drink and bathe with salt, it will affect us. That is all foolish. That is not going to help you. Some people are thinking in themselves because of the locality where I am, because of the place where I am, because of the color of my skin. That is not going to help you. Follow all the necessary precautions that has been given by the scientists and the people that are protecting disease. They have told us what we need to do. Follow the rules of hygiene. Wash your hand as many times as you can. Watch it. You go out to wash your hand. You come in, you wash your hand. Everywhere, wash your hand. And don't use that hand to rub your face. That's major. You don't hug, not because you don't like that person. You don't shake hands with anybody, not because you don't like the person. No. When you are going to cough, cough on your fabrics. Don't even cough in your hand or cough in your handkerchief or cough in a hand in toilet rolls. No. Cough using your elbow to cough like this. Yeah. Then you cough on it. Cough on your fabrics. Not only that, we are told to avoid crowd. Don't go to, in fact, you can even stop going to cinema houses now or going to movies or going to some of those other places. Restrict yourself for these few weeks. Let this problem be overpassed. When you are talking to another person, stay about 6 weeks, 6 feet away from them. And beyond the signs of all these deadly things that are going on in the world, let's put our faith in Christ. We are going to pray now. And I want us to pray very seriously. Join your faith with me as we pray together. Let's rise up. Let's close our eyes. Let's begin to pray. Let's ask the Lord that God has been our helper in the time past. Psalm 63 verse 7 says, because you have been my help, God has been there, be your help. God has been there, be my help. Because you have been there, be my help, therefore, in the shadow of your wings, I will rejoice. I want us to lift up our voice. I want us to pray. Oh God, you are my helper. I thank you because you are my helper. I praise you because you will help me. I want you to commit yourself into the hand of the Lord. Oh God, you are the helper. You are the only helper that can help me. In this situation, oh Lord, you will help me. All this problem, all this storm, all this plague that is going around in the world, Lord, please help me. Call upon the name of the Lord. Lord, you are my helper. You will help me. I believe in you. I trust in you. I trust in your power. Oh God, help me. Pray. Our God is there to answer your prayers. Our God is there to deliver. Our God is there to help us through. Oh Lord, help me. Psalm 46 verse 1 says, God is our refuge and strength. The power of the living God is our refuge and strength. He is the very present help in trouble. He will see us through. Yes, he will see us through.
But what the apostle says, what then shall we say? If God be for us, who can be against us? No. No power, no disease, no calamity can rise up against us. Hallelujah. President Trump says, will you pray? That was Sunday 15th. We are praying that God Almighty will deliver the land all over the world. God of heaven, he will send his deliverance upon us. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our Father and our God, the God who is the same yesterday, today, and forever, the God who has been stopping plagues in the time past, the God who has been providing solution to people's problems. When the children of Israel don't know where to pass, Lord, you saw them through. When they were going through the storms of life, you delivered them. When they are way between the enemies that can destroy them, you came to their rescue. Almighty God, you are the only one that can rescue us from the hand of the wicked one. Father, we are praying and we are calling upon you. Wherever your children are praying all over the world, concerning this problem, this plague that is facing us in the world, oh Lord, we are praying. Let your mighty anointing, let your power, let your coverage cover us around, all over. Let there be no plague to come near us. Father, David confessed. He said, on my right hand, thousands. On my left hand, thousands. He saw them, and none of those problems came upon him. Lord, we are praying. None of this plague will come upon any of your people. All the people that are hearing this message, all the people that are listening to this message, all the people who are not even listening, oh God, but they are people of yours. Lord, we decree and pray that this problem will not touch them. In the mighty name of Jesus, Almighty God, we are praying. We are taking authority over this plague. By the power in the name of Jesus, anything that will destroy the creature of God, that thing has to be destroyed. Lord, we are praying that you will use your power, you will use your grace, your anointing, your power, your mighty hand to deliver and destroy. Deliver all the people that are held captive, all the people that have been tested, and those that are carrying this problem, deliver them from the hand of this terrible, terrible plague. In the name of Jesus. And Lord, we are praying that your mighty power, that your divine power, that your miraculous power will remove this from the earth. You conquer all the other viruses that came upon the world. If you destroy this virus in the days of old, and you are destroying them in our contemporary age, we know that we destroy these. Father, we are praying that you give our scientists the wisdom, the understanding, to be able to devise something to counteract this problem. In the mighty name of Jesus, we commit the doctors and the nurses into your hand. Let your mighty power deliver them. Father, form your protection upon them. Let none of them lose their life in the process of saving the rest of us from trouble. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, we pray you cover them with the blood of Jesus. Lord, we pray that as they go to war, all the hospital workers, all the people that are connected with other wars, all the people that are trying to save us from the hand of this wicked, wicked storm, Father, protect them too. Father, we pray that your name alone will be glorified. Thank you, Eternal Father, as we individually continue to pray and cry upon you for you to solve this problem and remove it. Lord, let it be done. We believe you, God, that when your people call upon you, you answer. Father, please answer us. Remove this problem. Before the next 1 or 2 weeks, let's forget about this virus. Blessed be your name, because we know you have done it. We commit our governments into your hand. Lord, we pray you give them wisdom in every nation where they are. Give them wisdom to know how to control this and, you know, quell this problem and destroy it completely. Only you, God, will help us. Thank you, Eternal Father, because we believe you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you, my loving brethren. God bless you. We'll see you again next week. Thank you. Have a blessed time. Bye-bye.